Okay, good afternoon. Very good afternoon. Hello, can you hear me? Okay. Good afternoon to all of you. This is Hassan, and I will take few classes related to the communication. Okay. Can I start right now? How many people are there? 1, 2, 3. Nitish, Namni, Sonali. Well, the unit 3 of the syllabus is all about the communication. So we will try to understand today couple of things. Number one, what is communication, right? Then how communication happens, okay, in the personal life, in social life, in professional life, okay, how communication happens. Okay. Then we will also try to understand, okay, what are the functions of the communication systems, communication process. What role it has in our life. Then we will also discuss what are the different types of communication happens and at what levels. Okay. So today class will be focused on all these things. All right. Okay. The first one, communication. What is the communication? What does it mean? The very common term, we use this word in our day-to-day life. We used to say communication. So we are using this. So what is it actually? If you look at the communication which happens in our family, with our friends, you know, in our organizations, in our colleges, in our schools, okay, it means that okay, there are certain ideas, certain thoughts, and those ideas or thoughts are being transferred to the other person, right? Again, this is the communication, okay, the ideas, thoughts, feelings that a person has is transferred to the other persons. This is the communication. Okay. So it can also be said as the transference of meaning. You know, whatever the meaning I have about a stimulus, about things in life and in the world. So usko transfer karna, okay, that is called as the communication. But it is not the communication. Just transferring the ideas and thoughts from me to you is not communication. Communication will happen only when the other person, the you, are able to understand those ideas and thoughts. If you are able to understand, the only then we can say that the communication has happened. The communication is complete. Right? Again. So in this way, we can define the communication as the process. Communication, it is a process of transferring meaning or transferring of ideas and thoughts from one person to the another person. Okay, is a process. Okay. And other person gives feedback, okay, whether I have understood the idea or thoughts or not. Right? Okay. So communication to happen, communication will happen only when the process has following steps. You can say like this. You know, the number one, sender. The first process of the communication is the sender. What sender means? Sender is the person who develops certain ideas, who creates certain ideas, and sends that idea, share these ideas. It's called as a sender. So communication process involves few things. Number one, you can just note down. Number one is sender. Second is encoding. Third is message. Fourth is channel. Fifth is decoding. And the sixth is the receivers. So these are the steps. These are the steps involved in the whole communication process. Okay. So the first one is the sender. Sender is the person who has an idea and he wants to communicate those ideas, who wants to share those ideas or thoughts on any particular issues or on anything. Okay. Then those ideas are being converted. Okay. Ideas क्या होता है? Convert होता है. Convert in the form of thoughts. It is organized. which help in the communications. This process is called as encoding. Ideas is organized into a proper thought, in a proper formal thought process is called as encoding. Then, this thoughts is being communicated. This is called as a message. So whatever the thought is being communicated, that is the message. And it is communicated through channel. We have certain channels like verbal channels. We can also communicate through phone. We can also communicate through email. We can also communicate through social media like WhatsApp. We can also communicate through other means, letter or memos. So the idea which has been created and converted is shared. This message is shared by using some channels. Then this message through channels reaches to the person who is called as receiver. So receiver, so that receiver basically receives those ideas and try to decode it. They try to decode it, means they are trying to understand what actually the ideas is. So when they are able to understand those ideas, those thought, those information, that is called communication has happened. Communication is complete. All right. Okay. Clear? Now, what is the function of communication? Communication, what role communication plays in us? Communication is very important in our life. It has multiple roles to play in our life. The first one, I can just find out a few things. Communication gives information. Communication provides information to the person, to the targeted persons. Anything, any information we want to convey through others, it is also possible, it will be only possible through the communication systems or communication. Unless and until we will not communicate, those informations will not reach to the target person. One of the important things that it provides information. Information could be of related to anything. For example, in universities, that what kind of information will be, like when the classes will start, when the examination will start, when the form will fill up, when the result will be declared, when the admission will happen. So all this in organizations, communication, information is about the goal of the organization, policies and plan of the organization, strategies of the organization, new development in the organizations. So whatever the information that it is, this information is provided to the target audience through the communication. So the first role is that provide the information. Second role the communication plays is control the behavior. We control the behavior in our house, in our families, in our societies, in our institutions, anywhere. We have to control certain behaviors, and that is only possible through the communication process. If we will not communicate, then how the person's behavior will be controlled? How can we give the direction to the person? You are expected to do, you are not expected to do. You are expected to behave in a certain way, you are not expected to behave in this way. So it provides directions. It provides controls to the behavior of the people. In organization life, management controls the behavior of employees by providing feedback. How you have performed, what you are expected to do, and how much you have achieved that thing. So this is another function. Third function of communication is that it provides motivation. We have from time to time, we have to motivate our people, wherever, in each and every walk of life. And that motivation can happen only through the communications. करते हैं उसको कि हाँ आप ऐसे करो यू आर डूइंग वेरी गुड यू आर इफ यू विल बिहेव लाइक दिस दैट विल बी बेटर इफ यू विल कैरी ऑन दिस एक्टिविटीज इन दिस वे दैट विल बी बेटर सो बेसिकली इट इज एन आइडिया ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग द मोटिवेशन सो मोटिवेशन प्रोवाइड गिविंग मोटिवेशन और मोटिवेटिंग द पीपल इज हैपन कैन हैपन ओनली थ्रू द कम्युनिकेशन राइट ओके वन मोर इट हैज फंक्शन इज दैट इट प्रोवाइड समटाइम्स ऑफ इमोशनल एक्सप्रेशन because we are a human being, we feel a lot of information from morning to the evening, some positive emotions, some negative emotions. And how can we, sometimes we have to express our emotions to the people, to the family, to the society, or to the people working in the organization. And that expression of emotions
both positive and negative, can happen only through the communication. Because है ना हम अगर feel कर रहे हैं, suppose अगर अपने छोटे से या अपने subordinate से if I'm not happy, that is negative emotion. Then I have to share. I did this in feeling. And this feeling can only be possible when I have to communicate, है ना? कि तुमने ये किया, गलत किया, मुझे अच्छा नहीं लगा, या तुमने अच्छा किया, है ना? I realize I am very happy, है ना? So whatever the motivation, whatever the emotion we have, that can also be possible to transfer those information through communication process. So this was one. These are some of the basics, है ना? The function of the communication. All right? Okay.
Now channel. You can see channel will take later on. Communication direction. Communication hota kaise? What are the different directions of the communication systems? Communication has basically three important directions. Our communication happens in three ways. Three directions. Number one is called as upward communication. Yeah, bottom up communication. Second one is top-down communication or downward communication. And third one is called as lateral communication. So direction of communication happens through ways. One is called as upward communication or bottom-up. Second is downward, top-down, and lateral. Lateral communication. Now, what is the top-down communication? I'm taking one by one. What is the top-down communication? Top-down, the name itself makes very much clear, are those communication which happens from top to the bottom level in an organization, in the society, in the family. Because every organization or in any group, there are some persons who are manager, who are the leader, who are the head of the institution. So any communication which is coming from there and directed to the subordinates of the organization or the family, then that is called as a top-down communication. Right? Okay. So communication flow from top to bottom level. Top-down communication. Now, when this communication is used, when you will use this communication, suppose when you will be working in a particular organization, then in what circumstances you will use this communication? This top-down communication can be used when you want to convey important information as a management, as an owner, as a top position holder or head of the institution. If you want to convey certain decisions, certain strategies, certain policies, certain programs, or any kind of decisions, so that will happen through top-down communication. It is fast, and it is very second thing that the communication should be very much clear. If you are making a top-down communication, then communication should be very much clear. There should not be ambiguity. It should be clear. Okay. The more ambiguities will be, then there will be more confusion and the communication will disrupt, right? So this is the situation where you can use this communication. But advantage is that it is fast, it is quick, it is targeted communication, which reaches to the person concerned in a shortest period of time. Okay? And it has a deep impact on the behavior, in the change of behavior and thoughts of the people, top-down communication. Bottom-up communication, as the name itself made clear, it happens from the lower level to the upper level. Right? Okay. This type of communication is also used in the organization. Whenever people or the employees wants to convey some message or to give to some feedback or want to make certain changes in the policies, programs in the organization, then this type of communication happens. Okay. And that is called as a bottom-up communication. Another type of communication is called as lateral communication. Okay. Lateral communication. Sometimes communication happens between same level. For example, a teacher or one principal is communicating to the principal of one college is communicating to the principal of another college. Okay. So that is a lateral communication. One manager is communicating with another manager. That is a lateral communication. One professor is communicating to another professor. That is a lateral communication. That is an example of lateral communication. this type of communication also happens in the organization. And all these types of communication is important for the smooth functioning of the organizations or for the smooth running of the organizations. Communication is of various types. One is called as oral communication. Second is written communication. And third is non-verbal communications. The three major types of communication. Oral communication, at the name itself, makes very much clear. The communication, which takes place using words, using sentences. It is very direct. Here people speak to the concern, to the target persons directly and using words or sentences. It is the most efficient type of channel of communication, or you can say it is most of the efficient types of communication. If you want to have a good communication, it is better to have an oral communication, right? Because it helps to clarify any confusion. Suppose if I am saying something to the other person and other person are not able to understand, then he can raise the question, what actually you mean? What do you mean by this? So it helps in clarification. It helps in removing the confusion in the communication process. And it has a more impact, and deep impact on other person's communication happens. Second is called as written communications. Nowadays, since long time, we are using the communication through written also. And here we are using some memos or some emails or some notices, some orders. So that is written. We have to write something, the message on the paper, or nowadays we have to write, nowadays is the age of IT. So people are writing the messages in mail also. And through mail or through papers, they are sending the message from one place to another. That is called the written communications. We all know that thing. But it has some weaknesses. Although it is good that it can be sent to any point, at any place in the world, at the short moment, particularly when we are using IT. But written communication has one major weakness, is that the person or the other person may face some confusion in understandings. Because it is written, the person who is communicating the message is not available at that point of time. So he may not get quick clarification. For that, he have to write the person back and needs clarification. But it takes time. So this is the negative side of the written communication. Third type of communication is called as non-verbal communication, where the person is not using any words, where the person is not using any sentences. Rather, they are using or communicating the ideas or messages by body language. People use sometimes body language and to provide some information or to communicate some messages to him. And this sometimes non-verbal communication is more effective and more fruitful and more has a deep impact on the communication systems or understanding of the people compared to the verbal communication system. In one research, it is said that 75%, it has the impact of this communication, non-verbal communication, is 75% more than other non-verbal communication system. So this is another method of communication. Now, one more thing is that how communications disturbs barriers of communication, effective communication. We do communication, we try our best to communicate in a proper way, but sometimes communication doesn't teach us to the person properly, or the other persons are not able to understand the communication, what the previous person was saying or the one person was saying. I mean, there is a barrier. Some barriers happens, and because of that, communication distorts. So what are those barriers? It is also it is also necessary to understand these things, barriers of communication, right? There are a few barriers that help in distorting the communications. The first one is that filtering, F-I-L-T-E-R-N-G. Filter, the name itself makes clear. This is chhan karke aana hai na. It means that when communication happens from one person to other person or third person, then at each and every stages, those informations are being filtered, कुछ घटाई जाती है, कुछ जोड़ी जाती है, राइट? ओके, तो उससे होता है क्या है कि ओरिजिनल कम्युनिकेशन समटाइम्स, ठीक है, डजंट रीच टू द टारगेट पर्सन, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द फिल्टरिंग. So it the basic essence because of this, the basic or the essence of the communication disturbs and communication fails. You know, the person, the message that wants to give the person one person by another person to the another person, wo wahan tak nahi pahunchta. Okay, second barrier is called as selective perceptions. Sometimes we are not able to perceive properly, we are not able to understand the communication properly, okay, because we perceive that communication in a very specified manner. In a very specified manner, we normally, what happens, we take those information sent by the sender, which are fitting to our interest, which are fitting to our thinking, which are suitable to our own attitudes or own motives or interest. और उससे क्या होता है कि हम ओनली वी टेक दोज इन्फॉर्मेशन, बाकी जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है उसको हम छोड़ देते हैं, ठीक है, और जिसके वजह कर समटाइम्स वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कम्युनिकेशन प्रॉपरली, वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द आइडियाज थॉट्स सेंट बाय द सेंटर्स इन द टोटैलिटी, ठीक है, सो दैट ऑल्सो हेल्प इन द डिस्टॉर्शन ऑफ द पर्सन. थर्ड इज समटाइम्स वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द थॉट्स और आइडियाज सेंट बाय द फर्स्ट पर्सन बिकॉज of the information overload. So third factor which creates barrier is called as information overload. What happens? Sometimes we receive so many information at a time that we are not able to understand anybody's thoughts, anybody's ideas. For example, what happens in the class, when a teacher asks a question, then at one time several students give the response. So in that process, what happens is the teacher is not able to understand anybody's response. Okay. And this is a good example of information overload. All right? Okay. So this is one factor that creates disturbance or barriers in the effective communication. Another factor which works as a barrier in the effective communication is emotions. Our emotions also influences the way we perceive information sent by the persons, sender. Okay. Sometimes, because we are a human being, okay, we always experience some emotions. So, for example, if I am in negative emotion, hamara mood kharab hai, I am depressed, or I am anxious, or something has happened, you know, I am in a stressful situation. And if anybody comes with good idea, or maybe for normal work, then what happens, or say something, so our this emotions basically dominates in understanding of the inform of the message that the one person is communicating. Sometimes what happens, if without understanding we just react, ya fir kya hota hai ki chuke depression mein hai, stress hai, tension hai, so whatever he is saying we are not able to give pay attention towards the other person, ki what he and she is saying. So in this process, if he says something and goes back, then probably we are not able to understand what actually was the information he wanted to give. Similarly, it happens in the positive emotions also. Another factor that creates barrier in emotion is called as language. We can easily understand how language happens, creates a problem in understanding. If the sender sends any communication, any message in a particular language, and if we don't know the receiver, don't know that language, or not very good in that language, then what happens? He or she is not able to understand the ideas presented by the first person or given by the senders. This is very common here, or with us also. If we are, for example, we are very weak in English. Okay. So sometimes what happens, if any information which is coming, particularly in oral language, okay, and for somebody that's speaking in English, and because we are not very good in this language, so sometimes what happens, frequently what happens, we are not able to understand properly or completely what he or she is speaking, right? Okay, forget about the other language because we don't know any other language. So any information coming in that language, we cannot know anything. So language provides works as a big barrier for us understanding. Culture is another factor that also sometimes becomes barrier for effective communication. because some communications or culture specific. Okay. Any particular, any words, any thoughts, any words, any sentences, particularly words I will use, okay, is very specific to the culture. But like that particular word has one meaning in one culture and another meaning in another culture. Right? You know? For example, this is, for us, this is a non-verbal communication. You know? For us, we can say it is a perfect. But probably for in Australia, if you will use this word to indicate the perfection, to appreciate somebody, then they will take in another sense because for them, this symbol means something else, right? Again, so culture, in this way, we can see that, we can say that, or we can realize that how culture influences the communication process, again, or in what you call making effective communications, right? Again, okay. Communication apprehension is another factor that influences the effective communication or that works as a barrier for the effective communication. Now, what is communication apprehension? Sometimes what happens, we or some people, not all, some people are very much anxious about the communication, particularly the oral communication or written communication. उसे बहुत डर लगता है कि कोई written communication आएगा या फिर oral communication होगा, है ना? Varies करता है from individual to individual, ठीक है? तो वो डर, the feeling of that communication, ठीक है? Creates a tension in the person, and because of that, he or she is not able to understand the communication system, the communication or ideas properly. So these are some of the barriers which works as an effective communication system. Any other barriers? Probably, language. Language has already been done. Emotions are written. Okay. Prejudice. There is one more factor which works as an effective barrier in effective communication. That is called the prejudice. We are human beings. We are biased towards something, some people, some groups, some thoughts, some ideas, something. So suppose, for example, if I am biased towards some group, and if any communication coming from that group, so this biasness, this my perceptions about that group may also influence my in understanding the ideas. We will not be able to understand, or probably we will not give attention to those persons or to those groups, okay, because I am biased or we are biased towards that. Hai na? Jab usko attention hi nahi denge, to phir hum samajh kaise payenge ki wo kya kehna cha raha hai. So these are some of the factors that work an effective in an effective communication. तो ये तो था, इट्स ऑल अबाउट द कम्युनिकेशन. ठीक है, तो हम आज यहीं पे स्टॉप कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, प्रोबेबली वी विल कंटिन्यू और आई विल डिस्कस दिस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. टेल मी, बताइए
सर. आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सर प्लीज सेंड द नोट्स रिगार्डिंग दिस टॉपिक. मे यू प्लीज सेंड इट.
आई विल आस्क दिस थिंग्स फ्रॉम द कोऑर्डिनेटर. मुझे नहीं पता, आई डोंट नो. ठीक है, कि is it possible or it can be done or not. Okay, and then I will let you know. Okay.
Or so I'm giving you one. Your WhatsApp number.
Hello. My number, what you will do? No, number you don't take. Okay. First, let me clarify it from the coordinator. Okay. Then I will let you know. In the next class, you can ask from me. All right.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Otherwise, I can give you the name of the or a book. Okay, so you can download any book related to the communication, effective business communication. There are plenty of books available online, free of cost. It can be downloaded. From there you can take this, because all these things are available.
Excuse me, sir.
Bataiye
sir, may you please give the name of the coordinator. Tell the name of the coordinator. Name and number.
This I don't know. This no, I cannot give you the name and number exactly right now. You can take it from office. I don't know, because I was this task was given to me by coordinator. So just giving name and number without their permission is not appropriate. You can understand things. Okay. आप पता कर लो जहाँ से ये classes conduct होती हैं वहाँ आपको मिल जाएगा. ठीक है, फिर आप बता देंगे.
Pardon sir.
हम आप उसके मतलब बिना उनके परमिशन के आपको उनका नंबर नाम नहीं दे सकते हम. ठीक है.
Yes, yes.
ठीक है, आप मेरी मजबूरी को समझ सकते हैं आप. ठीक है.
Yes, yes.
I am here for a resource person.
ज्यादा कुछ कर भी नहीं सकते, ठीक है।
तो भाई दिन रात काम करता है, थोड़ा सा एंजॉय करने गया है। सबसे पहले तो कुछ
क्लास नहीं होगा क्या?